Hey, everybody. How's it going? Sitting on my monitor. Dan Schinder here on Trump Talk TV live if you're watching live, or on the archive if you're watching the archive. It's pretty simple. How are you? How's it going? What are you up to? Where are you? Oh, there we go. Where are you? I'm in Globe, Arizona, 100 miles east of Phoenix, up in the mountains. Gonna play some Steely Dan. Gonna do 4 songs and then I'm out. But I decided to play some of this because it's actually, even the simple songs are hard to play. So I found a cool live bootleg. I'll read the info in a moment, with Keith Carlock playing drums on this one. And as you know, Steely Dan has had some amazing drummers play with them through the years, and reeling in the years. And I'm not going to play that song. some really cool stuff going on there. So let me do this real quick and then silence myself. Just give me a sec here. I'm gonna pulling it up on my laptop so I can see your comments. Like I said, tell me where you're watching from, what's going on. I'm also gonna do a drawing. I've got one of my little drums here full of names and emails, full of emails right here. Gonna do a drawing for people who contributed to a couple surveys through our focus group. And if you want to join our focus group and do really quick, fun market research surveys that we do for a chance to win one of my books and a Drum Talk TV t-shirt, we've got like 3 dozen designs at drumtalktv.com/shop. Sign up for the focus group. It's a lot of fun. We're got a bunch of new surveys planned. So the people who participated in the last survey or two are in that drum, and I'm going to do a drawing in between a couple songs. So where are you watching from? What's going on? John F. Flaherty Jr., how are you? What's going on in Boston? Come from Wisconsin. Again, Rich Christensen, thanks for joining me. Jeff Jice in Nigeria. Thank you. Got lots of fans in Nigeria. Lots of drumming there. Hi from Kitchener, Ontario, Hoser. Nice to see you, Paul. Thanks, Paul's page. Cool. William Smith, thank you, thank you. Keep it coming, keep it coming. I'm going to start, and then I'll come back to comments. Be adventurous, folks. I'm probably a little too adventurous, and I don't mean always playing music that's too complicated, but playing the music I'm not that familiar with. And what I mean is this. I know these songs from, like, the album that I play to. I'm sorry. I know the songs I play to from the studio album and many live official versions and bootlegs, depending on the band, like Genesis, yes, Led Zeppelin. I know all their bootlegs, but there's a lot of bands like this one, Steely Dan, where I'm going to play to a bootleg that I just found this morning. And I picked out 4 songs, so I don't even know how the songs end. I'll probably cut them before the ending. The guitar solos are much longer. So there's all these unknowns, and that's okay. So I decided to play Steely Dan just to play something different and something I hadn't played in a long time. I'm on the little kit. Many of you see me on the big giant blue kit, which is what this drum's from. It's my smallest drum, but I'm on the little kit today, and we'll play some Steely Dan live from the Beacon Theater in New York City, October 2013. So it does feature the late, great Walter Becker, of course. I was in a band before most of you were born, and our main guitar player, Blaine Hoffman, was a combination of Walter Becker and Steve Howe. Nothing else. Those two. If those two had a kid, that'd be weird. But you know what I mean. If those two taught one student, he'd come out like Blaine Hoffman. Guy was amazing. Probably still is. Haven't talked to him in a while. Okay, here we go. You'll know the song. Let's do this. Hold on. Hopefully this will sound good. You let me know after the first song. Hopefully not too hi-hat heavy. Let's see if I can do this. All right, ready, folks? Here we go with some fun. Chime in. Tell me where you're watching from. Let's start with some Deacon Blues, their opening track from this night. Let's see what happens here.
Just to be made,
said in the beginning, it's a live version I'm not familiar with, and I don't know where it ends. Hey! Okay, there you go. Deacon Blues. So, I highly recommend, if you're a drummer, probably other musicians as well, that if you play a style on the periphery of the vein of Steely Dan or way outside of Steely Dan, if you play really progressive music, really hard rock, really hardcore traditional jazz, I highly recommend playing to any Steely Dan music, because while all music is really about the timing, there's something about Steely Dan music that is so pristine in the way the songs are put together, and of course the way the studio albums were put together, and then the way they're performed live by different drummers through the years, from Dennis Chambers to Peter Erskine to Keith Carlock, like on this recording. So it helps me with my playing. It keeps kind of brings it back for me, rather than when I play like Sound Chaser, Close to the Edge by Yes, or the live version of A Whole Lot of Love from The Song Remains the Same, stuff like that. And this kind of just brings it all down and trims all the fat. But let's do a quick drawing real quick. This is for the people who participated in the Drum Talk TV focus group surveys. And you can sign up for the focus group. It doesn't cost anything. You'll get an email with surveys. And if you want to take them, take them. If not, don't. But if you do, you're entered into a drawing. That's my pen. So I've got a bunch of names here that I'm not going to look at. They're folded in half. And each person is going to win one of my books, which is Social Media Marketing for Musician That Works, Volume 1. And a Drum Talk TV shirt, and you get to pick out the shirt. Here's one. If a band has groove, thank the drummer. We've got like 36 designs, and all the proceeds from shirt purchases, even when I buy them myself to give away, are profit proceeds that the shirt company gives us. I donate all of that to the American Diabetes Association. So check it out, drumtalktv.com/shop. And the first person is, I'm not going to do a drum roll. Someone else do that. Here we go. And I'll look at comments right after this. First one is, their email starts with Christy Yule. That's CRISTYUHL. I won't read the rest of the email address for privacy reasons. CRISTYUHL. Wins a shirt of her choice and a book, Volume 1. And book. Okay, there's one winner. Number two. Hey, let's see what we got. And chime in with your favorite Steely Dan. Forgot what we were doing here. Your favorite Steely Dan song. We'll see if it's one of the three that I have left to play. This is, oh, I know who this is. Wells Sean 77, if it's the Sean Wells, I think. Sean, congratulations, and thanks for taking part in our surveys. Shirt and book. Okay, and by the way, if you win and you live in a country where the shirt company doesn't ship to, they ship to almost every country except South Africa and just like literally a handful, I will make arrangements to still get it to you. I'll have you, well, we'll figure it out. Don't worry. I'll email you. Next one is Lee Jonathan F. at, that person knows, Lee Jonathan F. is the next winner. Congratulations. One more to go. Shirt. Book. Next one. One more. And then three more Steely Dan songs and some conversation about music and drumming and their music and drumming. And J.E. Gilbert at notgonnatellya.com. J.E. Gilbert, congratulations. I'm guessing J.E. are the first two initials. Shirt and book. If you want to be in the running for the next one, sign up for the focus group. Is that four? Yeah, that's four. Okay, let's keep it moving with music. But first, let me look at comments. Thanks, everybody, for participating. Let's see what's happening, what's going on, and who's saying what. Let's see what we got here. Oh, yeah. Pretty, absolutely laid it down with some serious groove with Steely Dan. Daniel Black is waving to someone in the gent in Nigeria, Nicole Linda. Thanks. Hello, I'm from Kitchener, Ontario. Also, wow, I wonder if you two know each other. Ooh, from Down Under, Gareth Scott in New Zealand from NZ. Thanks for chiming in. Destination of the Sydney to Hobart yacht race, which I made a documentary on about 12 years ago. Lived in Australia for a while. Thank you, Pauls. Or Paul, I guess that would be. Mike Daniels in Myrtle Beach. Beautiful area. Thanks for chiming in, everybody. Nice, nice, nice. All right, here we go. Next Steely Dan song. Chime in with your favorite Steely Dan song if you have one. And next, I'm going to go down the song list and just pick the other three. Thankfully, they're time-stamped. Oh, this is Peg. I shouldn't have given it away. Y'all would have guessed it, though, right? I'm on the wrong lever. Can y'all hear me talk very well when I'm talking? And does the music sound all right? Steve, maybe you could text my phone or someone mention it in the comments, either or both or all of the above. All right, here we go. Let's see, Steve says. Sound good, Steve? Maybe that didn't, but here we go to some music. Let me know after this song. Actually, I'll check the comments real quickly. Sounds good. Okay, thanks, everybody. Tyler, Steven Schinder, thank you. Sylvain in Quebec, how's it going, eh? Here we go. Let's see if I remember this one. Oh, but there's an ad coming. Let me let the ad pass. One sec here, waiting for the ad. What's with the ad, like, right after the song starts, right? All right, here we go. Yeah. How do you like that trick? So if you're just joining us, Dan Schindler here on Drum Talk TV, coming to you from Globe, Arizona. Tell me where you're watching from and how you're doing. I hope you're doing well. Playing some Steely Dan, a bootleg from 1993 that I've never even heard before, so I don't know the ending, so I'm kind of... That's my safety net, just stop before the ending that I don't know, right? And there's some extended guitar solos in a couple songs, so the song's a little different than what I've been hearing on the radio for 50 whatever years I've been hearing it. So cool, let's check comments, see what's going on. Anyone have any questions about Drum Talk TV? We got some amazing things planned. In fact, pretty soon, within a month or so, we're going to start reaching out for talent calls and grooming some future Drum Talk TV VJs. What? That's right, we're going to be doing that. And we've got our returning series that's back and rolling already. Three of them, this one, Dan's Almost Daily Vlog. Drumming Injury Talk with Dr. Nadia. I don't have the calendar in front of me. It's on the February... it might be 17th or 20th. This is Saturday. Anyways, you'll find out. If you follow Drum Talk TV, we'll be advertising it. And the show I do with drummer Jason Gianni called Tribute to the Tributes. And next up this month, we have a band called Awaken, an amazing tribute to Yes. And we've already got a band picked out for the following month, which I won't reveal yet. We've also got new interviews being rolled out. The first new one happened last Saturday. Carmine Apice has been a supporter of Drum Talk TV from the very beginning, 9 years ago. January 2013 is the first year I interviewed him, and he's been on many times. He won our Rock Legacy Award, and in fact, in the interview, he gives us a tour of his new studio in Florida, and he shows the special place where he's got his Drum Talk TV award, right next to Jesus, in fact. And he shows Civil War-era drumsticks he's got and a letter from Fred Astaire. It's a great interview, and he pays tribute to late Tim Gobart and our friend Phil Chen, who I had the honor of working with on the Ox and the Loon documentary, Brian Tichy and Joe Sutton's tribute that they did about 6-7 years ago. So, yes, lots of stuff happening. Follow what we do. Be a part of it. All right, here we go with more. Oh, let's take a look at, let's see, Tyler says, I'm listening to Boz Scaggs on vinyl while watching me play. That's weird. Am I getting it right at all, Tyler? That was funny. Thanks. Can't hear me singing. Good. That's probably good. Hey, Wayne Sims, what's up, buddy? All right, cool. Here we go with... share this to other music fans if you think they... might like it. Okay, here we go with the next one. We got two more. Great drumming on these songs, not by me, but by the original. I'll save that song for another time. But we're going to go with Josie. Oh, this, man, I don't know this version. I know this one's extended. Let's see what happens. Here we go. I'm nervous about this one. I'm playing with my glasses on, which is weird. I normally don't do that.
commercial, really? There's a commercial in the middle of the song. I muted it. We'll come right back to the regularly scheduled program in just a minute. It's cool. Walter Becker is just so cool. I can't help but watch at the same time. Walter's playing this like light seafoam green Strat. Just beautiful. What an amazing player and writer. Here we go back to your regularly scheduled program. Forever guitar solo that I'm not familiar with. Okay, one more. But first, let's check comments. And the next one happens to me. My voice cracked. I'm still going through puberty. It almost years old. My favorite song is Up Next by Steely Dan. Tell me what yours is. And let's see what else is happening here. What's going on? Hey, Brad Birch, what's going on? How are you? Michael Dominic, hey, love Steely Dan. In fact, I was just listening some earlier today on Sirius XM Radio on Classic Rewind. They played my all-time favorite songs, Asia. Oh, that's another one of my favorites, but it's not the next one that I'm playing. But it's one of my favorites, absolutely. And in fact, on this bootleg, Keith Carlock does an amazing solo in that song, Asia, but I'm not going to play that song. I'm going to do my other favorite Steely Dan song next, but still checking comments. Thanks, everybody, so much. If you want to support Drum Talk TV, be part of what we do, sign up for the focus group, buy a shirt. All the proceeds go to the American Diabetes Association. That's a cause very special to me because I found out 2.5 years ago I have diabetes, which is whack, which is weird. But hey, it is what it is, and so I'm doing what I can to help raise money for research and for people who can't afford what they need. Wayne Sims from One Drummer to Another. You're a good drummer, Dan. Thank you very much, Wayne. Kind of hacking away at a recording I've never even heard before. Thanks. All right, here we go with, and we're on the little kit today. Maybe many of you have seen me on the big kit. Next is, you'll see, it's a surprise. It's my number one or two favorite, along with Asia, by Steely Dan. Here we go. Can you guys hear this ride okay? This is a very special ride cymbal. I bought this in 1979, brand new. I'll tilt it a little. That didn't tilt much. It's an Earth Ride by Zildjian, has no grooves. It's very heavy, nasty looking, but nice and dry. Love this thing. Before I had a gong, I used to use this as my gong with a big mallet. It was over here on my big kit, but now it's on my little kit as a jazz. All right, hopefully you can hear that okay. All right. Thanks, Steve. Okay, here we go. With Name This Tune. This is my favorite, which means I'll totally botch it up, I'm sure. And I normally don't play with glasses on. That's weird. All right, let's see if the old man remembers this one. Oh, yeah. I remember how it starts, I think. Familiar with. All right, there we go. Dan's Almost Daily vlog. Thanks everybody who won the drawing for the book and the shirt, who participated in our focus group survey, the last one. We got more coming up. If you're interested in being a part of that, they're fun, they're quick, they're easy. So easy a drummer can do it. So if I can do it, you can do it. Sign up. The link is in the text of the post. We got more lives coming. We have a bunch of new interviews being booked, including interviews on the podcast I do with my son, Steve, called Yes Shift. We have a page at facebook.com/YesShift. If you're a prog fan, a Yes fan, check that out. Tonight, we're interviewing Adam Sears of Lobate Scarp. What's the connection? John Davison of Yes and Billy Sherwood of Yes sing on their new album. And we are actually expecting an email today, tomorrow, to secure a date with Oliver Wakeman, Rick Wakeman's son, who's done a lot of stuff with Yes and a lot of other stuff. So lots of fun stuff coming up on Drum Talk TV and otherwise. Thanks for following what we do. I'm really excited about the stuff happening this year. And soon we're going to get very soon back to multi-camera shoots. And I will have my foot cam back in action so that we can talk about stuff like this. Doing that with one pedal. All right. Thanks, everybody, for joining me here on Drum Talk TV. I appreciate it so much. I'll come over there, turn off the camera, because my wife is in here. She's hanging out with our new puppy, Sasha, a Shepsky, German Shepherd Husky mix. But Enja will be back working the controls soon on the multi-camera shoots. And we'll do stuff back here. We'll do stuff on the big kit. Here, I'll show you the big kit real quick if you're not familiar with it. Although it's missing a cymbal because I have it on the little kit. But this is, whoa, that's a little close. But this is the big kit. If you haven't seen it, there you go. And there's another little drum that goes on the end there that's actually being used right now for the drawing that I did. So thank you so much for joining me. We'll see you again soon.